Hey, what's going on, everybody? Rolling Pin Podcast. I'm jumping on here this morning. And whenever you see this, to pretty much shout out some more artwork while talking about what's currently going on in professional wrestling from my point of view and what I've been seeing, what I've been noticing. What's been catching my eye and my attention from the artwork to the current events. I'm going to dive right in. I want to start off by bringing up Gosh Lewinsky's art of Bobby Lashley slamming Keith Lee. Keith Lee just made an appearance back on WWE Raw after Bobby Lashley ended up defending his his WWE Championship and winning that against Kofi Kingston. We thought Kofi Kingston was going to win. I thought he was going to win. I didn't know what was going to happen because Bobby Lashley was feuding against MVP, telling him that he was getting soft and whatnot. So I thought that was the end for Bobby Lashley's reign, giving Kofi Kingston another chance. However, that didn't happen. It proceeded with Keith Lee coming back and being slammed by Bobby Lashley. I wanted to bring this up because I just want to say, I don't see Keith Lee. I thought Keith Lee was going to be a legitimate superstar coming into the WWE when he first made an appearance on the main roster. However, he's been thrown around in different locations since he's been on the scene. So, you know, I hope Keith Lee isn't getting buried right now. I hope there is a bright future for Keith Lee still. Maybe he'll do better on the SmackDown side of things, but it hasn't been good for Keith Lee this far. But Bobby Lashley, you know what I mean, still looking like a good champion to run with. So shout out to Gosh Lewinsky for the digital art. And keep doing your thing, guy. You know, I always see Rolling Pin Podcast. I want to bring up Richie_Inkwell. We don't follow each other, but Richie, make sure you follow me, because what I do on here is I make sure I shout out wrestling artwork, and yours caught my attention as you used the hashtag wrestling art. So good job on doing that. I wanted to bring up Aleister Black. As a whole, the wrestling art community has been putting out a lot of Aleister Black content. It just shows that they do support Aleister Black and his decision going to AEW and finding a home and continuing his role as Malachi Black. I'm sorry, we're going to switch it up now. Malachi Black. I want to bring this up because this is a cool Disney, throwback Disney Malachi Black. Something you don't see every day in the art world. Somebody doing it this way. But this is dope. You know what I mean? I like this. It's very cartoon style, you know what I mean? Disney needs to fucking sign Malachi Black onto their fucking program on Disney Plus or Disney. I got the Disney Plus app. I just thought about that. But Malachi Black, as a whole, you know what I mean? I'm glad that he's found a nice spot. And shout out to you, my guy, Richie_Inkwell. Make sure you follow the Rolling Pin Podcast and keep up this type of artwork. So fucking dope. I need to get into digital art too. You know what I mean? Shit's hot. _Outland. Shout out to you first and foremost. Hope everything's going well with you and yours. I wanted to bring up Edge because Edge is back. However, Edge was defeated by Roman Reigns again after interference by Seth Rollins at Money in the Bank. This isn't the first time Edge has been interfered with during Money in the Bank. Edge was fucking pissed. You could tell as he continued to just lash out on Seth Rollins after the match ended. Edge is still in the mix, you know what I mean? Even though Edge didn't win that Universal Championship, Edge is still in the mix of things, you know what I mean? He's not going anywhere. He's still running with Seth Rollins, Roman Reigns, and now John Cena, which we're going to get into pretty soon. For my next one, elbow drop art. John Cena is back. I'm not a big John Cena fan, but I know how John Cena affects the people. You know what I mean? John Cena is a superstar by definition. You know what I mean? But I gotta say, with John Cena being back, it is definitely gonna shake up the wrestling world. So I am glad that he's back, even though I'm gonna probably be going for Roman Reigns in this situation. You know what I mean? Because I don't need goody two shoes John Cena taking the championship from Roman Reigns. That's not how it's about to go down. I need Roman Reigns to beat John Cena. That's how I wanted to see that happen. But elbow drop art, I can't see John Cena, so this is perfect. Shout out to you for this elbow drop art work. You know what I mean? Switching it up. Big E recently got the Money in the Bank contract off that ladder in that big mashup. This is great for Big E. This puts Big E back into the running to go after whatever championship he chooses in a year's time. I don't know what championship he's gonna go after. I think my personal opinion, I think he needs to go after whoever is the weaker of the two. Roman Reigns is holding that motherfucking championship pretty tight right now. I don't think it would be best to go up against Roman Reigns when you got Edge in the mix and everything else. Bobby Lashley, you might have a better chance against. I'm just going to say that, Big E. But I'm not taking away your heart as a champion. If you feel like you want to stay on SmackDown or you want to go after Roman Reigns or John Cena or whatever the fuck is about to happen, then do that. You know what I mean? Either way, actually, if you go for the SmackDown Universal Championship, that's going to put you more in the superstardom. The WWE Championship right now, it's with Bobby Lashley, and Bobby Lashley is a superstar. You could take that title, but I think you'll look better with the SmackDown one. That's all I'm going to say. You know what I mean? Shout out to Tom.Q.Art for this Big E. And shout out to Tom.Q.Art for this John Cena. You know what I mean? I had to bring up Tom.Q.Art twice because he is so consistent in his work. Tom.Q.Art, you're so consistent in your work, and you always are, staying relevant to what's going on in wrestling culture and wrestling art culture. So I wanted to bring you up twice just to say thank you for keeping it this consistent and keeping me consistent on shouting you out. Looking at it again, we got John Cena. This time I can see John Cena. And I think Roman Reigns going to be able to see John Cena too at SummerSlam. So in Las Vegas, we're going to see what happens. But I really believe that Roman Reigns is going to beat John Cena. For real. I ain't no way. Unless John Cena was training underground somewhere for a very long period of time. If he's been sitting on this couch this whole time and just think he's going to get up at SummerSlam and just defeat Roman Reigns, he got another thing coming. I get that he's a superstar, but he ain't losing that championship. That's my early prediction. Lindsey Ray Gunn, shout out to you for this Samoa Joe. I watched Samoa Joe last night on NXT, and I got to say, I'm very, very impressed by Samoa Joe's promo ability and also his in-ring ability as well. Right now, he's going after Karrion Kross, saying that Karrion Kross needs to be under control. And Samoa Joe is the guy who wants to put Karrion Kross in his place because Karrion Kross has been on Raw. Karrion Kross is beating up William Regal. Karrion Kross is doing whatever the fuck he wants to do right now down there on NXT. And Samoa Joe is saying, look, I'm the guy that's going to put Karrion Kross in his place. So right now, Samoa Joe is doing the right thing by going out there and Karrion Kross and trying to give him some order. And I just want to say shout out to you too for this this Samoa Joe canvas. It looks like you painted it diagonally. I love the backdrop on this too. That's pretty dope. Let me know if you painted the backdrop first and then you put some more draw on there, or did you do the opposite? You know what I mean? Did you do some more draw first and then the backdrop? Either way, this is fire. Your technique looks great. Is this acrylic? That's fire. That's fire. It's looking good. Looks like some pen work in there. I don't know. That looks good though. I want to bring up mine too. I had to bring up my junkyard dog. Well, this is actually called Art Yard Dog, but it's other junkyard dog, and it has mixed media components. I got the paper clip down here rattling like it's the chains of junkyard dog, so you can actually rattle that if you wanted to. Just don't take it out of the plastic. I went ahead and added some scrap metal on here because, again, I'm just looking at junkyard dog's history, and it was basically saying that he got his name from working in a scrap yard. So I put a lot of metal into this. You know what I mean? It's not even that heavy. It's perfectly fitting inside of this plastic. And make sure y'all check out the sound art and also take a look back at my Art Yard Dog piece. It's fucking phenomenal. That's pretty much all I had so far in wrestling culture. Make sure y'all comment on what y'all have been witnessing in wrestling culture on any of the topics that I've just witnessed or I've been looking at or that I've discussed. Y'all comment and y'all let me know what y'all think about what's going on in wrestling right now, because it's always good to hear from y'all. Rolling Pin Podcast is Gary Fools. Y'all make sure y'all have a great day and continue making that great artwork. Peace.